You only pick the pigs on this island or the waves. Radio waves are not even waves anymore. There are no pulses either on the rail top.
That's because they're changing the analog signal and replacing it with a digital one.
This is not a witch predicted.
Which witch?
She's not a witch. She's a beachcomber by day and a moonmaker by night.
How can she comb a beach? You can't even comb her hair.
She doesn't comb her hair because it causes too much static interference. And when she touches something metal that will conduct and charge, and it will discharge onto her and she will get shot.
Charge, discharge, it's all more of a trouble to me.
Hang on, who's that? She sounds familiar.
It's her! James talking about her!
She looks familiar!
She's combed her hair!
Oh man, we're in for a shock if we touch her!
Hey! You'll get more than a shock!
Sit!
You'll get a punch in the nose!
It's just a tree!
How did you know that? You must be a telepathic witch or something.
I am telepathic. I know everything about everything.
Where's your friend?
Well, if you are really telepathic like you say you were, you would know.
Professor jamming device was on at the time. I only have a small window of opportunity to get the information that I need.
Maybe if you cleaned your little window of opportunity, you might be able to see things more
clearly. I asked you a question. Where's your friend?
Luke didn't make it. We fought the octopus, and I survived. But he didn't. He died trying to help me save the world.
I have a strange feeling that saving the world is not enough when it comes to friendship.
Oh yes, and how would you know that? Are you really psychic?
Aye. I knew you'd want that. I used to receive signals before the mobile phone, you know. But now all the masts and transmissions, they cause me interference.
Cross lines.
Aye. I did make a bit of money out of it, you know. Intercepting mobile phone calls as it shouldn't be missing, having access to the ransom machine stuff. As usual, the news of the world spoiled that, nice little London. Now I get no news no more.
Was it true about Tommy the Trumpeter?
It could be. That toast curl and your cheeks go red.
Come on, give us a bit of scandal, man. No! Not Tommy!
Twice!
Oh, Tommy!
Enough of this! Why is he here?
He's here to save us!
Him?
Aye.
I thought he would be smaller.
Surely you mean taller?
Don't call me Shirley, it brings back bad memories.
Officer said you would be small and, you know, chunky.
Small and chunky?
We need a torrential and fat no.
Quiet! He's from the other world, are you mental? You don't cook this one properly, you'll get food poisoning, boy.
Oh my god.
Stick it on, country.
It's nearly sunset, brother. We're sacrificing the Shearer.
The great god of the night.
Oh, great. Under the frying pan and in the fire.
And then, at dawn, let's put a stake in him and burn him.
Bring him! We must get him to the altar and prepared. The darkness approaches.
Come on, we're not going to do this, so we're just going to, you know, run.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have an update on the current situation. We have two of our senior agents on the job, and at the moment, they have gone dark. It's all hush-hush.
What he is trying to say is, we lost contact with them over an hour ago.
These two individuals are highly trained for this kind of work.
They haven't got a clue.
God is on our side.
God help us all.
I have complete faith in our men in the field who are risking their lives.
Expendable.
Me and you are going to fall out big time if you keep contradicting me.
If we fall out, I'll withdraw my support. Then where will you be?
Okay, you handle this one as the Deputy Prime Minister.
Okay, I will.
Off you go then. Let's see how you do it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have an update on the current situation. We have two of our most brilliant operatives on the case. Nothing will stop them.
I concur.
No, this is wrong. No, here, turn it off. I swear I can do this. I'm not an idiot. Just give me a moment to compose myself. Let's not get personal.
Let's just start again. Why on earth have you sent Adam and Luke to save the world that don't have a brain cell between them? What?
Adam
the DeLorean, that he's been chipped.
What? Like a dog?
Why?
Don't bring me into it. It's been bugged back in my day.
What do you mean, bugged? I mean chipped. We believe, and his father, when he was a boy, we believe his father had him chipped.
Why? Did he used to run away a lot?
No. We found out about the microchip when he was arrested at Newcastle Airport last week. When he returned from Amsterdam, I didn't realise airport scanners were that sensitive. No. The Alsatian which was 200 metres away caught him out.
I'm looking for Adam. Dog must have been downwind and caught away from the air.
No, not quite within the air. Airwave could be precise. The security scanner in the arrival cell was on the blink. Set the wrong frequency. Adam's microchip reacted with the scanner, giving off a high-pitched whistle. Coming out of the deep sleep and thinking his master was calling him, he made his way to the airport. Adam was standing in the security scanner, trying to keep his pants up because they take his belt through the X-ray machine. The dog thought he was a drug smuggler and started barking at him. Adam immediately lifted his hands in the air to surrender, and his pants fell to the ground. He was arrested for an intentional by law for flashing himself to a dog and being a danger to the general public. Any questions?
The chip isn't just the chip, is it?
No. The microchip gives off another signal, which we will believe will open doors for us. And there's also a certain transmission bug into it as well, which we haven't ascertained the meaning of.
Adam's the key, isn't he?
About desert islands and what the white get, little small puppy for smell of cheeseburgers. Ow! Oh, come on!
Time for breakfast. It's heavy when it looks.
Why we always have to collect deadwood every day?
Hey, who you call deadwood?
Oh, let me see. What?
You were washed up on the shore. We'll pick you up. We're taking you to the Temple of Light. We're going to put you on the fire. And you'll burn us a daily sacrifice to Shiva. Deadwood.
Oh. Well, I'm not liking the sound of it. I'm not liking the sound of it either.
It would not be long. You won't be a thing once you're dead.
Huh? Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa. I know my rights. You come here without my lawyer. What is it, Amnesty International, when you need them?
When a princess, when a lady princess took Robotti's henchman, gag him.
Hey. I haven't had a fair trial. The Amnesty International had a field day of you lot. I'll be a defender!
Pressure groups, you're let the dictating policies and justifying your own existence and having a job for life.
Until they get the Puritans sit in the House of Lords.
Which is what they're after in the first place.
Yeah, they don't complain then, do they, Lady Chuckleberry?
Punish them from back door.
Shortcut ruling the world.
You're like a bunch of builders on a coffee break.
Tea breaks all up.
We don't need much help, Temple, cop our own back!
Have emotion then, we have a lot to answer for. Gag him, we have to go.
Exactly, the rest of me kill is wrong, fuck you!
Our agents aren't very bright because he couldn't afford the tuition fees to attend university.
Because you wanted power and didn't have the balls to stand up to me.
And they aren't well trained because they actually reduced the deficit.
That was my idea.
And they certainly won't get a pension. Because my associate here keeps upping the retirement age and, well, they'll be dead before they ever reach it.
Hang on, Cleggy. Except if you are a member of Parliament, then you can retire with a fantastic pension. I have seen to that personally.
Oh yes, Canners, even if you are a crook or extremely rich, you're going to get one, if not two.
Got to keep those birds in the lifestyle they're accustomed to, eh, Nick?
You said we would never talk about that. Anyway, I have a super injunction in place, so that will never get out.
Claims. You have just outed yourself on live TV to 12 million people. I was making a joke about Sir Peter Biggers, who claims expenses for his bird house on his leg.
Oops.
You should never say never again. You always put your foot in it.
Where's Vince Cable? I only keep him in the Lib Dems, you know, it's that gaff me. Vince! Vince! Vince, where are you?
Calm down, dear.
You just called me dear in front of 12 million people. I'm going to have to get another injunction in place. Just so people don't think mean you are.
You know, Cleggers, you have just lost the plot.
What? The plot to destroy the world in the next 20 minutes. I've just said that out loud, haven't I?
You certainly have. Never mind our whole parliament. I'm going to bring back hanging, and you're going first.
Right, that's it. I'm withdrawing my support. You're on your own.
That means you are on your own. And the Lib Dems will disappear in front of our eyes.
Right. After thinking about it, I'm going to do U-turn right now.
Good man.
world, and I'm the only man who can do it.
What? You're a man? Ha! Yeah. You could have fooled me.
I am a man.
Yeah. If you said you're a woman, would we not sacrifice you?
That's a bit harsh, isn't it? A bit sexist.
Not really. They would have put a woman to work in the kitchen while we go to work. We don't want any strangers hanging around.
Especially men who aren't indigenous.
I'll have you know I had a girlfriend once.
Exactly.
Look, so this isn't about your son sacrifice to your sun god Shira, is it not? It's about your own insecurities. Why don't you just get a fence and build it around you?
What's one of them?
It's like a wooden structure, you know, that you build around and keep people out and you apart from civilization.
Don't need a fence.
No, I suppose you don't need a fence. You live on an island surrounded by water and killer fish.
Don't be silly. There are no killer fish out in the sea.
Yes, they are.
Oh, that's not a giant octopus. Ain't no killer fish.
I had an encounter with one of them octopus things. All pink and tentatively and suckery he was. I live to tell the tale.
Hey, he's got a name. But man, if you just give him a chance, you know, ain't he right? You know, his name's Nathan, you know. He's my best mate. You know, when I'm tired and sad. He gives us a cuddle.
Oh, come on, guys, you should rejoice in calling me your saver after battling that giant pink octopus of the sea. You should be calling me a hero after killing and shredding that giant octopus.
Look! Look! You're alive!
Oh, yeah. No fancy you doing a runner.
What did you just say you did?
I killed that giant octopus. I put him up in 2 reef knots, 1 granny knot, 1 clawfish, and I finish him off with a half inch. But saying that last knot was as long as the rest, mind you.
Hang about, did you say 2 reef knots?
Yeah.
That's 4 tentacles, all right. A granny knot, there's another 2 tentacles, there's 6 tentacles. What was the other one you said? A reef knot. A reef knot, there's another 2 tentacles, there's 8 tentacles. Octopus 8, fine. But then you finished him off with a half hitch. That's another tentacle, that's 9 tentacles?
Yeah.
You've tied 9 tentacles?
Yeah, I counted as another little, I'm not stupid.
Octopus has 8 tentacles and you've tied 9 tentacles.
Oh! Oh no, didn't, did I?
Yep, you did.
Oh no!
He's got a slow cook! We'll make him suffer like a lobster!
Hey, you're starting to go pink.
I'll pink you in a minute.
You left me to die and swim away.
Hey.
Watch, I care about you.
I've got to save the world. You, under the circumstances, are expendable.
I'm expendable, you under the circumstances, once I... Get off these ropes!
Oh, what's the matter? I thought you were good with knots.
Look, I'm not good at knots, just not this type of knot.
All right, so what knot are you not so good at? Are you not going to see?
Look, I may not look like I know what I'm doing, but that's not the case.
Yes.
And you two, stop bickering for 1 minute. Every time I turn into an argument like an old married couple.
Yes, well, I'm sorry, but we're trying to untie the knot of excuse upon.
Well, he started it.
Shut up.
Listen, if you distract them for 2 minutes, we'll be able to escape in the dark.
How are you going to do that? Turn the lights off?
Aye. How do you know that?
Well, educated guess.
No, it was a lucky guess.
Distract them and keep them busy, right?
Right. Oh! Look, he has got something to tell you.
Oh, cheers, mate. Excuse me. Excuse me. About your octopussy.
Oh, poor.
I'm sure he'll be okay. I mean, I only tied him up in knots. And not only something else, man. Okay, this is one. Right, okay, I had this girlfriend once. And she tied me up in knots. And she left out in a big mood. And I was stuck there for 4 hours. And look at me, I'm all right, look.
And that's where his infatuation with knots come from. His mom couldn't untie him. Isn't that horrible?
Not as horrible as we are going to be.
Oh, God.
Take
Hey, no. I want my phone call. I want my lawyer. Where's Andy? I'm with the International Wing in Needham.
Probably living up in a Torben shop in Geneva.
I know. Guys.
The God of the Night Brothers! He's bringing the darkness to the sun!
I'm curious. Why does this always happen at night time?
It happens at night time, you just don't see it because you're asleep.
Just the air. The sun never come out at night.
Oh, you got me there, little fella.
Your back. My popularity is gaining momentum. We're now serious contenders for government, don't you think?
You damn fool! After that performance in front of 12 million, I think you might be on your own.
Oh, I'm sorry, Prime Minister. I'm not doing it again.
Promise?
Cross my heart and hope it does.
Oh, Cleggy, die another day. We have a world to save before supper's ready.
The world is not enough. I want more. I'm going to continue to support you and your party.
Colleagues, for legal reasons, it's a coalition. Do you understand?
Yes, sir. Three bags full, sir.
Good. That's what I like to
eat. There's a camera. Could you have a word with Mr. Murdoch for covering up a news story for me?
You said you wanted transparency in government. Do you or don't you?
Please have a word.
Are we agreed then? When we talk to the public, it's do as I say, not as I do.
The politician's way. One for all for us.
This microphone is still on. Oh, bugger!
Is that camera still on? Oh, heck. But I still look good.
Are you kidding me?
I shall see this only once.
Right, that'll make you feel better. Listen carefully, I'll say this only once.
No, it's not the same.
Listen! We've got to get Adam to the complex as quick as we can because time is running out.
Oh, I know time is running out, but why do you need Adam? Or why are you always there to save us? Or is it just Adam you need?
No, I need both of you, and because I've got to get you to my dad.
Your dad?
My father is Professor Ivor Represser.
Is this a trap?
No! I'm the one who's trying to stop him calm down, and to do that, I need Adam.
What? But what about me? Do you need me?
Well, you were expendable, surplus to requirements, but now I realise how much you Adam needs you.
Oh, what about Adam? Is he surplus to your requirements?
No, he's the key.
What?
Adam is the key. He has a key inside him. He just doesn't know it yet. Oh. And, listen, you can't tell him.
I can't tell him now, but I know. I mean,
oh, please,
I just can't.
Please don't.
Oh. Okay. Oh, let me guess. You're a spy who loves me. Right, okay. I won't tell my best friend your little secret.
This is ridiculous. I look like I've got a funeral.
But you're leaving off.
Oh, well, yeah, Reggie, at last I'll see you in about time, too. You know, we've got something to do here.
Come on.
But listen, there's something important I must tell you both while you're together.
Over here, right. Let's get them.
Oh, quick, Repressor's going to energize the machine, quick.
Oh, shh.
Sure, just saw the military and the car kid start.
This church is no good. I think we need a spotlight.
Another 5 minutes watching, and then they'll add those two jolly fools, and the lifetime work will come to fruition.
Professor, when we do the rewind, would it be possible to stop off at the...
I shall rewind back in time 20 years and come face to face with that fool who has caused me frustration and anger for all these years.
Professor, I didn't realise you didn't like me.
Not you, you fool. The other fool, Dr. Ann. I shall go back and have the foresight knowledge to realise what he was doing. When he sabotaged and reprogrammed deep dive, only the work with access from that microprocessor.
So you're going to stop him from falling out the window to his horrible death?
No, you fool. I will still zap him and push him out the window to a horrible death.
You're so bad, sir. So, when we do the rewind, would it be possible to stop off at, let's say, 10 years back? Then you can stop me from getting run over by the speeding car.
I can't do that, Ratchet. You see, it would cause a paradox, and we can't have that now, can we?
A paradox? What's one of them?
Wait, it's too complicated to explain. You see, I was the one that was driving the car. I knocked you down.
I don't understand.
I told you, I knew you wouldn't understand. Paradox is a very complicated thing, and I knew you wouldn't understand.
Oh, I'm getting even more confused. Oh,
that's easy done. You were just a working class politician, peasant. I could have been a politician.
Is that another one? Paradox thingies, or just people that live in a civilized society where everything's equalish.
I'm gonna have to get a bigger aerial.
All government cuts, that's why we're in.
And we haven't had the other situation, sir.
Everything going according to plan. Stop. They've made their way to the island. Stop. They've escaped from the little people. Stop. They are about to be captured by a repressor with a little help from.
Shh.
You know who?
Shh. No, I don't know who.
Shh. It's need not only.
Shh.
How are we supposed to be knowing that they're going to be captured?
Shh, don't tell anyone.
But how do we know?
Shh. It's classified.
Shh. What's classified?
Shh.
It's classified. All will be revealed soon.
Shh. I'm trying to listen to the cricket.
I feel like a band on the run.
Rings! I can do if I can't bother giving me rings.
What were you two talking about back there?
You know, I've been watching on this and that.
No, I don't know. Why don't you tell us?
Oh, come on, we need to go. There's not much time. Come on, let's go.
Hang on. Do you trust her?
Yeah, I think I do.
Okay, good enough for me. You haven't fallen for her, have you?
No, of course not. She's not my type.
Good, because everybody knows that love and science don't mix.
Hey, you used to say live and let live. You know you did.
I know I did. But in
in this ever-changing world in which we live in makes you give in and cry. Shut up.
Come on, the music
breaks
over.
No
more silly love songs. We've got a job to do, yeah,
haven't we? Oh, no.
Sorry about this, you two. But you're just so stupid of me falling for this trap. It's hardly even a clever one, is it?
Well, you said you trusted her. I should have known.
Oh, she seems so nice.
David.
Come on. Well, what does it matter to you anyway? When you've got a job to do, you've got to do it well. So you've got to give the other fellas hell. Leave and let die, that's my motto.
You do realise, Cleggers, if everything goes horribly wrong and Professor Oppressor succeeds, it will have to be another coalition.
Under the circumstances, I think you might be working for him. Or maybe I might be working for him.
Don't worry on that score. I think you are unemployable. Just think, you'll be out of a job. No hung parliament, no coalition government, heck, no government at all. Just an evil dictator to work under.
I can do that. I've been doing it for the past 2 years. In your government.
And, Cleggers, you've been doing it rather well, if I say so myself.
Why, thank you, Camus. That's the nicest thing you've ever said to me. In private.